Nothing to drill with?
Nothing to drill with.
Why is that?
I don't know.
You went to a John Danaher seminar this weekend, eh? I was also there.
You were there?
Yeah. How was that?
We drilled together.
Yeah, it was good. Again, like, if you've already studied a lot of his content, most of the information he gave was like already going to be familiar to you. But I could understand if it was like someone's first exposure and like didn't watch the instructionals, everything would have been gold for them. But the information's all out there already online, right? So it's just like, you know it. Seminars are more just like a fan experience, I feel like. If you want to see the dude, you want to meet him, get some insight, it's good. Otherwise, buy a DVD.
Let's go into our Underhook Delahiva game. So we were using this, I can't remember if it was last week or the week before, we were like using the waiter guard position. So we had the Delahiva here, and when they went to step over this leg, we were off balancing him here. If they stayed up in this position, we can start going into like X guard or single leg X. If they dropped to a knee, that was when we were using the waiter guard position to start scooping the legs and getting to here to do lots of like back attacks and into the legs and stuff like that. And you can also use this proactively. So if you go to a scoop Delahiva, you can start using this off balance to start going into X guard and waiter guard. So now let's look at more when we don't have the angle to do that. So it's like he's kind of giving us a little bit of an angle to the back here, but he's opening this knee. So if he was closing this knee, it's quite easy for me to get my foot to the outside and go backside 50-50 K guard stuff. But when he's opening the knee, it can make it difficult to get that angle. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna go to put this knee on the mat. So I'm stepping on this knee, I'm gonna connect my hands here, and much like when we take his heel off the floor for K guard, we're gonna do that same pressure, forcing his knee to the mat like this, okay? Now from here, I'm gonna step on his knee, and you notice my shin is still framing here, okay? The way I used to do this technique is I'd go deep Delahiva and I'd start swinging myself all the way up from here, but better guys would start to face me from this position. So what I do is I keep this shin framing here, so as he goes to turn towards me, I'm using that as a barrier. Now I keep that there all the way until I start to hug his hips, okay? From this position, I'm gonna start to post my hand, or I can even keep control of this ankle. I'm gonna start to scoop back, pulling his hips down towards me, okay? From here, I switch to regular hooks. I start climbing the back, getting my seatbelt on my hooks back. So we pull ourselves into Delahiva, and we go to a scoop Delahiva position. Right now, I have more of an angle to start going to waiter, but let's say he's hiding that leg forward from me, okay? So like this. So now I'm gonna connect my hands, and I start to turn his knee down to the floor like this. I will step on this knee. The reason I do that is because I don't want him like backstepping into this leg and going outside ashi and attacking my heel. So I step here and my shin is holding on, is framing on his hip. So now I shorten this hand, I sit up and I hug the far hip here. Now I'm gonna start to scoop back, okay? This foot can start to pull towards me and this foot can hook on his knee to stop him spinning. Now I just keep scooting back, climbing up, building a seatbelt, and get the back there.
How do you feel after learning from the wise Jonathan Danaher?
I've been changed forever. That was a fantastic experience. The depth of my understanding of John's teaching style and technique has now improved. I think I'm a better person, definitely a better lover.
What happened here?
This little head clash, punching underhooks at the same time. I hit his temple, his temple hit my this, and then just cut.
So he hit you with the better part of his head?
Yeah, hit the harder part of his head, hit, I mean the harder edge of my head, which yeah. Unfortunately split the skin, but it's all good, it's not bleeding. A little
good.
Blue, a little super glue.
Let's get a look at it. Every session, Andrew.
Every session you cramp, otherwise you're not trying hard enough.
Cramp!
Hill's grappling retirement home.
Chris, what are you doing, mate?
Just stretching.
What is happening?
I don't know. Potassium deficiencies. We got to keep some bananas, coconut water at the gym. These old people.
Oh.
Huh? You got buggy shirts?
Oh, no.
I tried the fish in the throat.
Yeah, worst case scenario, do it backwards. Just roll backwards, not too bad. They can't, they can't finish it.
Cool. I didn't get it on camera, Carl. I'm so sorry. Cramping again?
Really, look at that car.
Yeah, yeah. Impressive, very impressive. We'll get a better shot of it later.
He has impressive calves.
He needs some milk.
Reach through his legs with your left hand. Through the legs. Over this side. Over and through. There you go. Good. Use that to separate the legs now. Separate his legs. Keep your leg over. Stop pointing your knee down to the mat. Yeah, there you go. Sort of.
My lord. There's a heel-shaped gift right there.
The knee was out.
Oh my god.
Blood sugar's run away.
No! 3 seconds later!
One more round! You, Carl, you looked lifeless there.
He was just mesh.
It's the person in the fence.
Being very nice to me.
So what comps have you got coming up? International ones?
It depends when I get to the US, but I want to do as many IBJJF Opens as I can before Worlds, which is 1st of June. Maybe Pan Americans on the 28th of March, if I'm there early enough. And then, yeah, just one or two IBJJF Opens.
Yeah,
that's pretty much it. Worlds is the focus. So I don't really care what I do leading up to Worlds. Anything that I do is more just in preparation for Worlds. So we'll see. Pan Ams would be good, but it's in Florida, so it just depends if I can make it feasible.
Yeah.
But yeah, we'll just have to see how it goes.
Let's go.
But AJP is the next goal, man. $1,200, baby.
Oh, is that the prize money?
Really?
Yeah.
That's good. Yeah, break out the red panties.
That's right. Are you going to pass, Jordan?
Huh?
Are you going to pass? I actually taught this last night if you came.
Damn it, I'm trying to be close.
Oh my god. This is going on the YouTube channel to shame you. To shame you.
At least get the leg so mine doesn't.
Take your right heel under his heel.
Right heel?
Left heel under his heel, sorry.
Yeah, there you go. Use
that
to untuck your leg.
There you go.
Oh.
Holy shit.
Minute lesson.
Did you know that I actually can teach good things?
You?
Yeah. What, to children?
Oh, yeah.
To Jordan. And at all. And to children.
Talking about training cats.
What are you laughing at, bro? You're inside control.
I'm sorry. You guys are very entertaining. And this is very painful. I'm trying to bring my mind to another place.
Stand forward, I'll get your Dorito back.
Alright, great training. Good to see everyone here. Chuck your geese on, we'll start very soon. Hold on.
What are you showing us, Dad?
Show a bit of carb action. This is why I get cramps all the time.
Dang. Look at this. Hold on, let me turn the lighting down. Wait, go, come again. I turn the shadows down.
Good?
Yeah, go. Jesus.
Not ready.
You've been watching Hills Grappling.
You've been watching Hills Grappling.
Like and subscribe.
Like, comment, subscribe, share.